out there, just launched, in fact, by UCLA to help track the spread of coronavirus in our area.
In fact, it's called Stop COVID-19. Yeah. Well, joining us now by Skype is the lead project developer and UCLA professor, Aaron Halperin. This app is so interesting, Aaron. It looks at residents both sick and healthy to figure out where the virus is spreading. Can you explain to us how this works?
Yeah, so this app called StopCovid19together.org basically came about because of a need. When we look at what is going on right now in New York and in other communities, we see that what we have right now, we couldn't really imagine that that's going to be the case, let's say, a month ago. And what we want to make sure is that we can be prepared for this in the local communities here and around the world. And so the basic idea is that what we need from people is basically getting some information. So if you, the public, can go in and give us information through this survey about the spread of the disease, about your symptoms, about the exposure, and about things like social distancing, that could be incorporated into a model that we could then use to forecast what's going to happen in the local communities. So what you can see here, actually, in the screenshots, you can see this, the survey itself. Mm-hmm. In the survey, everything that we ask is essentially anonymous. The only thing that we ask, which is not anonymous, are the your address. And for the address, you can just, if you prefer not to give it, you can decide just to give the zip code, or you can just decide to give the cross street, which is next to you. And then the other thing that we ask is for your email, and that's optional, and that's only if you want to give us information later in a follow-up that we'll send you in a few days for a follow-up survey. And this is also very important for us for the modeling. And what is really important for people to remember is that if we have more information about your specific local community, we can have better predictions or better forecasting of what's going to happen in your community specifically.
Professor Halperin, let's talk about the map here. What are you seeing right now? Any hotspots?
Mm-hmm. Right, so we launched it essentially yesterday, so we don't have information right now, but basically this is kind of how a mock-up of how it's going to look 2 days from now, let's say, once we have enough data, and that really depends on the audience, basically on the public. If you give us enough information, then we can look at specific communities, and I think it's kind of in your screen, it's hidden, but what you can see is you can click on a specific community, and the resolution will depend on how many points of information do we have in that specific community, and then we can say what is going to happen in the next few weeks in terms of the surge, both in terms of the number of cases and in terms of the number of people that are admitted to the hospitals, and in the number of ventilators that we're going to need to use.
And speaking of hospitals, Aaron, how will this app help local hospitals? I'm assuming it's going to help them get ready for possible patients, right?
Yeah, exactly. So this web app basically came about because I was part of a team that what we're trying to do is we're trying to think about ways of kind of preparing again in the hospital level. So one of the things you can try to think about is try to see whether we're prepared in terms of the number of ventilators, the number of ICU beds that we have, and so on. But really an important part of this is how many patients are going to show up in any given day, let's say 2-3 weeks from now. And that part is something that we don't really have when we just look at the data in the hospital. Mm-hmm. So what we're going to do is combine the information from the hospital and the information that the public can give us from the survey in order to be able to do these predictions of the load on the hospital.
All right. Professor Halperin, thank you so much for taking the time to join us and telling about this new app. Mm-hmm. We wish you the best.
Yeah.
All right, from fashion to front lines, what Louis Vuitton is doing during the pandemic.
And not-